Very frustrating loss a week ago to Plymouth, 10-6 at Romano Field in Plymouth. A game that looked as though Weymouth North could have had four of the stealing as the Maroons were outplayed, but still had opportunities to pull the game out. Silver Lake, on the other hand, lost a very frustrating game to the Tigers of Taunton by the score of 26-16. Taunton scoring 20 points in the second half and putting away the Lakers in that game. Jeff Bartell of Taunton, two touchdowns, enabled Taunton to pull that game out. But the Maroons come into tonight's game, a situation where the Maroons are looking to get off to a much quicker start than they have had in the past couple of weeks. One thing about this Weymouth North team, in the three games they have played so far, they have gotten off to slow starts in all three games. Talking to Coach Joe Kelly before the game, I asked him about how much it concerns him about the slow start.
Well, I guess we just have to believe that what we're doing is right, and sooner or later we're going to get it right. We think we're a run and pass football team, and so far we've been able to run the ball, but we haven't been throwing the ball well in the first half. If that comes around, then we'll be very happy.
How about from the Plymouth game, though it is a tough loss, what can you gain out of that type of loss?
Oh, that was a heck of a football game by two good teams, and probably the team that was a little bit better that night won it. We probably learned that we are a good football team, and all we have to do is just keep playing the way we played against Plymouth, and we'll have a successful season.
Let's look at Silver Lake, not a good start for the Lakers, but still they can always be a pesky group.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it depends on how we show up on Friday night. If we show up to play the way we did down at Plymouth, we should be okay. If we show up still licking our wounds from Plymouth, then we're going to be in for a very tough night. And I don't think these kids want tough nights. I think they enjoy winning more than they enjoy losing.
What will be the key factors to beat Silver Lake?
Attitude, which is fine right now, and the belief that we can score a lot of points and we can shut down the other team, which I think we proved that we could shut down teams against Plymouth, but now we have to prove that we can go back and put some points on the board.
About set to start here at Legion Field as you look at Tim Stevenson getting ready to kick off as Silver Lake has won the toss and has elected to receive. They'll be going from right to left as Stevenson will be kicking to one of these three people, J.P. Duffy, top of your screen left, Frank Martin in the middle, and Mike Heaney is nearest to you. As a glorious, glorious October evening here at Legion Field, as temperature in the high 50s, no wind to speak of, and Weymouth North and Silver Lake about set to start. Pull up a chair. We think we're going to have a good one for you. And Stevenson with a high kick. Martin 10. Martin looks for the middle. It breaks loose. Martin could go. Stevenson chasing him. And Stevenson grabs him at the 35 of Weymouth North. Frank Martin with a sensational return right up the middle and almost went the distance. He was brought down by Tim Stevenson, who just hung on. As you look at the Laker offense, Frank Martin, the key person. As Martin, the key back, he has had the good success in the early going. Jared Snell, the only returning player for the Lakers this year. As you look at the rest of the Laker offense, and already some movement on the first play of the game, so a legal procedure on Silver Lake. And Weymouth North, I'll have it discussed with him, but Frank Martin electrifying the crowd right away with a sensational kick return. And legal procedure on Silver Lake, and it'll be first and 15 as the Lakers 0-3, but two of the games they had opportunities to win. The opener against Barnstable and last week against Taunton, but big letdown quarters have hurt Silver Lake. And they and the Maroons have had some good battles so far, some quick movement in the line, and Jared Snell, forget that play. The Maroon defense just bottled up Jared Snell. And that Maroon defense which got stronger as the game went on a week ago against Plymouth. As the front seven and the defensive backs, who in the first two games had 9 interceptions, second and 15. And Keith nearly went offsides as Martin dances away from one possible tackler, but can't get away from Alex Provost, as the maroon linebacker was there to stop him. As Teddy Keefe nearly went offsides, but the maroon defensive end did get back. But Martin got away from Matt Deedy originally and got outside and lost two. It'll be third and 17 for the Lakers. It's Frank Martin, excellent kickoff return, but the Lakers have run two plays and gone nowhere. And we'll see if Steve Erickson will pass on third down with J.P. Duffy in motion. And the screen being set up and overthrown, intended for Jared Snell, as a marker is down, as Lou Henriksen came across and got near Jared Snell. And this ineligible receiver downfield on Silver Lake. And I believe the Maroons will decline the penalty because it'll be fourth and 18 as Jason Capello gets the alternatives given to him, and Jason deciding that it will be refused, as it will not be a loss of down in collegiate and high school, and the Lakers have come to the line. And the fourth and 18. As Steve Ulo to punt for the Lakers. And a high kick. Chuck Montorio grabbed and hauled down at the 16-yard line. And Mike Dawson in on the tackle, and the Maroons will start at their own 16. And the Maroon offense, which struggled at times a week ago, but had one superb drive, had a good second half, as quarterback Tim Stevenson leads the Maroons out, leading rusher Rich Mraz. Stevenson had an erratic game a week ago, and he'll be looking to work on improving it this week, as Rich Mraz is stuffed at the line of scrimmage. As Tommy Cahill was there to trip up Mraz after a yard gain, and the Laker defense. As the Lakers, brand new defense. A year ago, the Lakers were a size team. They relied on physical beating of the other team. This year, the Lakers are a little bit smaller, relying a little more on the quickness. As on second down and 9, option pitch. And Chuck Montorio crosses the 20 out to the 24-yard line, 29-yard line. Check that. As Montorio will get the first down. As Montorio with the first down run out to the 29. Stevenson, a week ago, had an off game. He's looking to rebound from that off game. As the option to Rich Mraz, looking to turn the corner. Richard does just that. And Mraz out to the 40 and very close to a first down. As Frank Martin knocked him down. But Rich Mraz got out to the 40 and a first down. So the Maroons, after a 1 yard gain by Mraz in the first play, have been ripped off. 12 by Montorio and then another 11 by Mraz. Option, Strasseri. Strasseri turns the corner nicely. Keith down the sidelines in the Silver Lake territory and gets the first down. As Strasseri got away from Joe Rio and then this broke it outside where he was finally corralled out of bounds by Jared Snell. But the sophomore running back with a very nice gain in the Silver Lake territory of 14 yards and a first down for Weymouth North. 3 straight plays, 3 straight first downs. Lou Henriksen tries to go off tackle, and Henriksen stopped by Mike Heavey after about a yard gain. As Heavey sliced through and grabbed Henriksen. So after three straight first down runs, the Maroons have a run that does not gain a first down, but they've been able to get to the outside very quickly on Silver Lake. Stevenson, busted play, Timmy keeps, Timmy gets crunched by Rio. As Rio and Terry O'Hara make the stop on Stevenson at the line of scrimmage, it'll be third down.
Third down, about nine.
As we head towards 6 minutes to go in the first period. And the Maroons have moved from their own 16 to the Laker 44. And Stevenson on the bootleg pass. Shoots it in between Chuck Montorio and Lou Henriksen. Both were open, but Timmy just dropped it in there looking for one of the other to go after it. And neither went at, could get after it because it was too far ahead of both of them. So the Maroon drive apparently stalling out at the 44 of Silver Lake. And Stevenson the punt to either Heavey or J.P. Duffy. Low snap, Stevenson gets it, just gets it away, and a high kick. And Danny Daly will chase after it, and does he get it? Touchback. Danny Daly tried to hustle down the football, but Danny was unsuccessful. As Danny unable to keep the ball from going in the end zone, so the Lakers will start at their 20-yard line. As Silver Lake on their first offensive possession, marched absolutely nowhere, as after the great kick return by Frank Martin, the Lakers went backwards. And they tried Jarrett Snell up the middle, and Jarrett Snell caught at the line of scrimmage by the interior of the Maroon defense. Led by Lou Henriksen and Alex Provost. Snell, a gain of one, second and nine.
Tackle was saved made by Matt Deedy.
The Lakers have tried to go up the middle on the Maroons so far. Very little success on second and nine. Martin tries off tackle, and he gets tripped up because Matt Deedy came through, took on the block of Jared Snell, stripped the block, and tripped up Martin for a loss of three. And it'll be third and 13. As the Maroon defense, for the first five plays, have played exceptionally well. As on third down and 13, Erickson will go to the air and end the pressure and tries to hit wide receiver Steve Ulo, who was covered very nicely by Jason Capello, but a pass too high for Ulo and Capello, and it will be punting time for the Lakers. And Steve Ulo gets set to kick. He drills out a high kick. Mraz takes it, fakes the reverse, looking to head the corner. Rich does. Mraz. Touchdown, Rich Mraz. A high kick that Rich Mraz took and then got great blocking, had a good return to his right and had a great wall, and Mraz follows it 48 yards for the touchdown. And Weymouth North, with 4:06 to go in the opening period, is on top. Look, 6-0, and Tim Stevenson will look to make it 7. Stevenson does just that. Mraz on a 48-yard punt return gives the Maroons a 7-0 lead. Rich Mraz on a 48-yard punt return gives Weymouth North the early lead with 4:06 to go here in the first period. A dandy punt return by the Maroon senior running back. And Stevenson to kick off. Last time, Frank Martin almost broke it. It took a great tackle by Timmy Stevenson to prevent Martin from going the distance. And a high kick. Martin at the 10. This time, Martin will not get the great return. Danny Daly and Keith Trezeri bring him down. And Chuck Montorio also at the 24-yard line. And the Lakers will have it with their third possession starting there, as the Lakers so far have gone basically backwards. They lost 3 yards in the first series. They lost 3 yards last series. And the Maroon defense, as Erickson on the quick out, intended receiver Frank Martin. They tried to spring Martin from the backfield, get him out on a cornerback one-on-one, but the pass, a fade type of pass, Erickson threw it too far ahead, and it'll be second down and 10.
Second down, 10 to go.
Second and 10, it is going to be Martin met by Capello, small. And add to that group, John Serafini, as well as the trio. We're all there to grab Martin behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of one. It'll be 3rd and 11. The Maroon defense, the first 2 weeks of the season, they made life miserable for Braintree and Taunton. And it began this game doing the same to Silver Lake. They got stronger down in Plymouth. As Erickson the throw, tried to hit Ulo deep, but Chuck Montorio had the better shot for the football. And three plays and punt for the Lakers.
Bring up the fourth down.
As Silver Lake, first series at the Weymouth, in Weymouth North Territory, lost 5 on a penalty, 3 on rushing plays, and then an incompletion. Second series, they lost a couple 3 yards. In the third series, they've lost another 2, as Ulo will keep it away from Mraz and get a great roll out at the 45 of Weymouth North. As you look at longtime statistician Ben Ells jotting down where Ulo's punt went out. As Ulo with a 32-yard kick. And the Lakers on that series only held the ball for a mere 53 seconds. Stevenson, plenty of time. Overshoots Strazzeri. Strazzeri was wide open, but Timmy put a little too much on the football. It'll be second down and 10 for the Maroons. Offense, second and 10. Strasseri looking to turn the corner. Strasseri does with a marker down. And he's finally run out by Mike Heavey. And where the marker was thrown downfield will indicate a possible clip or hold on Weymouth North.
Back on the 50-yard line.
As Strasseri turned the corner nicely and clipping on Weymouth North.
Looks like a clipping penalty against
Prince
Weymouth.
The Maroons on that particular run. Keith Strasseri coming into this game has carried the ball 9 times, 97 yards, 63 on one dazzling run in the opening week against Braintree. And Strasseri will watch his first down run get wiped out by the clip. So far, the good news for Weymouth North fans is the fact that they started a little stronger than they have had in the past couple of weeks. But it's taken a punt return to get them on the board. It's Stevenson to Mraz. 45 of Silver Lake and Rich's dumped out of bounds there by Frank Martin, but Rich Mraz open and Timmy Stevenson floated it in nicely. First down, Weymouth North. On that pass from Stevenson to Mraz. Play Montorio. Fumbles the football, but they will rule the check was down at the 41.
O'Connor made the stop.
Down, and for Weymouth North, as Stevenson will keep, as he did not see anybody open, and Steve Ulo brings him down with Kevin Barrett at the 41-yard line. And for the Maroons, Stevenson gains a yard. It'll be third and 7. Stevenson, deep over the middle, wide open. Danny Lindblom. Lindblom, touchdown. Wide open, and Timmy Stevenson just threaded a strike over the middle, and Danny Lindblom outran Mike Perkins, and it's 6 points. Weymouth North with 1:26 to go in the opening period. The Maroons drive for the touchdown that puts them ahead 13-0, and what was worried about the slow start, they are not tonight. They have come out ready to play. As the clapping for the background was for Jeff Milton, who was shaken up on the play. And Stevenson will try to add to the lead as Timmy, with the touchdown pass, is first since the first week of the season. Stevenson drills it through. And his set fourth touchdown pass of the year to Danny Lindblom gives the Maroons a lead of 14-0. A 55-yard drive in 5 plays in the last 41 were an airmail special of Timmy Stevenson to Danny Lindblom. And Weymouth North off to a good start, 14-0. And Timmy with a high kick. Martin, 5-yard line. Martin this time looking for someplace to go and finds it. Stevenson slows Martin down and Darren Gladstone brings him down at the 46. But Frank Martin has had 2 excellent kickoff returns. Martin almost broke the opening kickoff going up the middle from about a 7 to the Maroon 40-yard line. This one, he starts at his 3, gets to the 46. And that one was all Martin. Is to get that play. How do you do, Matt Deedy? He was introduced to Mike Heavey as number 31, Mike Heavey of Silver Lake, met number 56 in a maroon and gold shirt and just buried him. And for a loss of two, it will be second and 12. As we're under a minute to go here in the opening quarter. Erickson in trouble. Eddie Norton drove him down. Back at the 32-yard line for a loss of 12. Eddie Norton led a group of maroon tacklers. And the Laker offense has just been non-existent. Four possessions here in this first period. All four possessions have resulted in minus yardage. As the Lakers will let the first quarter come to an end. And the cheering has belonged to Weymouth North here in the opening quarter. The Maroons on a punt return by Rich Moraz at 48 yards and a Stevenson to Lindblom 41 yard touchdown pass lead the Lakers 14 to nothing.
Every year, thousands of babies die from choking, suffocating, or other breathing emergencies. Just imagine how many of them could be saved if only they came with instructions. Please learn American Red Cross infant and child CPR. American Red Cross, we help you help others.
As the fans here at Legion Field have been treated to a fine defensive performance by the Maroons after a quarter, Silver Lake has yet to see positive yardage in this game. As the Lakers have had all sorts of trouble moving the football against a very quick and fired up Maroon defense. They're faced with third and 23 with two receivers. And now a third, Frank Martin in motion, heading top of the screen. And Erickson running into all sorts of trouble. Eddie Norton with a sack. And it'll be ruled that Erickson was down as Eddie Norton with his second straight sack of Steve Erickson. As Eddie Norton stops Steve Erickson. And it will be fourth down. And, well, from here to Kingston for a first down for the Lakers. And Steve Ulloa to punt again. And Ulloa with a high kick. Gets a nice roll. And a marker down. As it rolled dead at the Maroon 48, or was it where the official had marked the football, as where it will start. And first down, Weymouth North at their 48. Option, Strazzeri. Strazzeri turns the corner in the Silver Lake territory. Goes Keith Strazzeri, where he is bumped out of bounds by Joe Rio. But Strazzeri got a good block from Darren Gladstone in turning the corner and will have first down yardage to the Laker 42. So the Maroons have come out alternating back so far and been successful the ground game. Option, it is now Darren Gladstone turning the corner. Gladstone slows down as he was about to be hit. He was looking to make the move, but could not shake the Lakers' Marty Delaney as Gladstone gets six on the play to the 35. And it'll be second down and four for the Maroons. guys. The Maroons, you get through the running backs. They have a lot of talented people. We saw the opening week of the season, and they intend to use them more and more. As Stevenson decides to run, gets the first down and gets away and slips and falls. And he recovers the football as a marker down in the offensive backfield holding Weymouth North. But Stevenson's fine run to the 27, and if he didn't slip, Timmy was going a lot farther, but the Maroons will be backed up as a holding penalty on Weymouth North. And it pushes them back to the 46-yard line. And we head towards the 8-minute mark of the first half. 14-0 Weymouth North. If you just flipped us on the dial here on Dimension 36, I'm Mark Ducharme with you. As on 2nd and 14, the give is to check Montorio. Montorio gets tripped up after a 2-yard gain by John Dolan. As Montorio, in crossing the line of scrimmage, had his legs cut out from under him. It'll be 3rd and 11 for the Maroons. Stevenson, over the middle, deep, and almost intercepted by Mike Perkins. Danny Lindblom and Ed Norton both there. And the pass just overthrown. It will be 4th down and 11. And the Maroons are going to go for it on 4th and 11, feeling that their defense has been rock solid, and make it happen this way. And they go to the ground and be short of the first down, as on the inside handoff, Keith Strazzeri with good yardage, but he will be 2 yards short as Weymouth North in 4 possessions for Silver Lake. The Lakers have yet to move the football on the Maroon defense, so the feeling being, why not just challenge Silver Lake, see if they can make the move against Weymouth North's defense. They've been unable to. And the Lakers came up with a defensive play as Erickson had Martin, but Frank could not hang on to the football. Gladstone, Mraz, and Layton all over there. But the pass by Erickson was right there. Martin just does not hang on. 2nd down and 10. Lakers, it's got to be pointed out, a year ago, had some fine football players. People like David Hatch, Greg Solari, Craig Sampson, some good, talented football players. Lineman Fred Allen, one of the better linemen around. And the Lakers, a heavily senior Layton team, as they go to the shotgun on 2nd down and 10. With Erickson completing it to Snell, and Jared is cut down by Lou Henriksen at the line of scrimmage.
No gain on the play.
As Henriksen and company just made sure that nobody in a Laker uniform was really going to start moving downfield. As every avenue you look, there has been a Maroon shirt right there with a Laker shirt. And more times than not, it's been 2 or 3. The Maroons are just swarming right to the football, and very effectively. Erickson out of the shotgun on 3rd down. Airing it out deep. Incomplete. Intended for Mike Dawson, and Darren Gladstone was there on the coverage. As Darren and Dawson both had a good road to the football, but Erickson just overthrew. And Steve Ullo once again to punt.
Montorio and Morar back deep for the punt.
There's Ullo with a high kick. Fumble by Montorio, but Mraz alertly falls on it at the 38.
Down by
Rich Mraz falling on it at the 38.
38 yard line.
And the Maroons will start there with 6:11 to go in the half, and the Lakers unable to do a thing against the Maroons for the five possessions, and that was the best Silver Lake offensive possession. No gain, no yardage at all. Other than that, it's been minus so far. Henriksen straight ahead to the 43.
First up the middle.
64, Tony Currington. And 31, Mike Heavey put down Lou Henriksen. As it's a 5 yard gain, second down and five for the Maroons. As you look at the Laker defense, which is bent but only broken once, that long touchdown pass by Stevenson to Danny Lindblom, as it'll be Henriksen again in the Laker territory to the 49 and a first down. As Lou Henriksen just dive up the middle in the last two plays, and very successful. And the Maroons trying to open up with some good running on the inside, open up the outside where they could just make it happen. Rich Mraz, and that's the reason why they run inside, because Mraz takes it down to the Laker 23. Rich Mraz, last week only 19 yards running. He saw the ball only 8 times. It's got to be pointed out in fairness to Rich. After two 100-yard plus games. And the Maroons looking to add to the lead. And a fumble, Stevenson. With a broken play, advances it to the 24-yard line for a 3-yard gain. So everything the Maroons do wrong, they end up getting a break and getting something right out of it. Second down and 7 for Weymouth North, as 4:46 and counting left in the first half. 14-0 Weymouth North. Mraz, counter play, ran into his own blockers, but still makes a nice run out of it inside the 15 to the 11. Rich ran up the back of his offensive lineman, Alex Provost, and still made a nice run out of it, as Mraz is ruled down at the 12. And hello, Chuck Montorio, Mike Heavey. Arm tackles Montorio down after a yard gain.
Dawson made the tackle.
As Heavey just ripped them down on the play. Second down and 9 for the Maroons. And should point out, maybe at times you might hear a little light buzz in the background. If we do, because of the radio station WATD doing the game here, as Mraz on the sweep runs into Chris Ferrara and gets inside the 10 to about the 9. As Heavey bottled the play up, and Mraz is brought down at the 10. It'll be 7 for a first down and 10 for a touchdown. So I do hear that little buzz in the background. It is because of their antenna times, and that's the one problem we do have. Option, Strazzeri turns the corner. Strazzeri to the five, maybe the four. Where he is brought down by Jared Snell and Jeff Uva. As the two bring him down at the 5 yard line, it'll be fourth and two for a first down, five for a touchdown. As you take a look at the maroon offense, which is about to go at this fourth and two play. Mraz dances into the end zone for the touchdown. 2 plays ago, Rich ran into his own blocker, Chris Ferrara. This time, he just stepped around Ferrara and found his way into the end zone for the touchdown on a sweep right. And it is 20-0 with 2:16 to go in the first half. The Maroons on top. And Stevenson looking to add to the lead. Stevenson with his third consecutive point after. The Maroons drive, and Rich Mraz finishes it off with a touchdown run. 21-0, Weymouth North. 9 plays, 62 yards for Weymouth North. About the only thing that has gone wrong for the Maroons in the first half has been their kickoff coverage. Frank Martin twice has nearly broken it for touchdowns. Tim Stevenson with two saving tackles on both of them. And Stevenson decides to ground it towards Martin. Martin with another excellent return out to the 40-yard line. Frank Martin has been a superb kickoff returner. 2:10 to go in the first half. 21-0, Weymouth North. 2-0. First down, Erickson flipping it over the middle to Frank Martin, incomplete. 2:07 to go in the first half. Is
second down
for the Lakers and 10 from the 40. Erickson setting up the screen and somehow complete. Mike Heavey almost getting first down yardage to the 49-yard line, where Jason Capello brings him down. And it is very close to first down yardage. And the Lakers, if they do get it, will be their first down with 1:50 to go here in the first half. It has been all Weymouth North so far, and they do have the first down. Until 1:50 to go in the first half, the Lakers had not had positive yardage on any possession until now. That is how good that the defense you see on your screen has played here in the opening half. Erickson out of the shotgun. Quick flip over the middle, and Henriksen breaks up that play. Mike Dawson, the intended receiver, but Lou Henriksen had excellent coverage. Lou Henriksen, a superb linebacker. A year ago, 114 tackles as a sophomore. He has got an interception this year. He is one of the, he's always around the football. And remember in the Thanksgiving Day game, Lou Henriksen with a key fumble recovery on the first possession for Weymouth South. And the Maroons cashed it in for a touchdown. As Erickson throws it in a crowd. Jason Capello, Alex Provost, and Eddie Norton all there, all headed shots at the football. As Martin and Dawson were there for Silver Lake. And it was like a jump ball situation, and nobody had an opportunity to get it, and it'll be 3rd and 10 for the Lakers. As we have 1:26 to go until the half, Reminder, Weymouth South, North Quincy highlights at the halftime. There's the Wildcats and the Red Raiders going on at Veterans Stadium as Erickson with a pass for Dawson. Or check it, Ulo, incomplete. David Layton on the coverage. Ulo and seal Layton off. But the pass had to be thrown low and outside, and it was thrown too low and outside. And Steve Ulo will be punting. So the Lakers get a first down, their first of the game, but they only get one first down, and with 1:21 left, they will be punting to Weymouth North. Ulo with a good high kick. Montorio gets away from Martin. Now trying to reverse field. And he is unable to get away from 74. Terry O'Hara. As the Laker lineman was downfield to make a nice play on check Montorio. And we'll see if the Maroons up 21-0. The ball on their own 16 will just grind out the first half. And for the Maroon football team, with the speed they have, trying to grind out a first half with the speed can also result in a breakaway threat with a Mraz or a Strazieri. And the Maroons will throw. Stevenson, nothing there, keeps. Timmy, just running all over the place. Nobody to pass to. There's a marker down. And let's see if it stands up. What a run by Stevenson, no matter what. And let's see if the touchdown stands. And they're talking to the Lakers, and apparently, well, Stevenson will only have about, but the 84 yards get credit for a certain amount. And let's see. Unsportsmanlike conduct, Weymouth North. And let's see, and believe it will be assessed on the kickoff. 84 yards for Timmy Stevenson. And we'll show you the replay of that touchdown dazzling run by Stevenson after the point after kick. Timmy Stevenson with a great touchdown run as you watch it again, 84 yards. And the Maroons with a comfortable lead on this dazzling kickoff return by their senior quarterback. Okay. 51 seconds to go in the first half, and an 84-yard drive is nicely as you want it. Timmy Stevenson doing it all on that dazzling run. He found nobody to throw to and just took off. And there was an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty on Weymouth North on the touchdown. It was assessed on the kickoff. And Frank Martin, who will probably see a squib kick headed his way. And now Martin, instead of starting maybe inside his 20, will be starting a little bit back as the Maroons have come out smoking in the first half. And Stevenson drills it. And it was away from Martin. Good return by Marcus Lopes to the 42-yard line, and with 43 seconds to go, Silver Lake will have it at the 42-yard line.
Penalty occurred after the touchdown, and Weymouth was penalized 15 yards for the kickoff.
What a half for the Maroons. We have brought you halves that they have just been incredible so far this year. Marcus Lopes gains 2 to the 43-yard line, and the Lakers probably are just going to run out the clock here in the first half because the Maroon defense has just been devastating, and the big play by the offense have got the Maroons on top very comfortably here in this first half. And the Lakers taking all sorts of time. As we will remind you, Rich Mraz getting it started, and now they'll be able to run that one play left. And no, they won't. Erickson with a marker down, and what was going to be the end of the first half will not, because Weymouth North may have made a big mistake. Personal foul on the Maroons. A big mistake. A little over-aggressiveness cost Weymouth North 15 yards. Silver Lake, check it, we'll have one more play. That's an automatic first down. It'll be the second one for the Lakers in the half. But the point of the story has got to be the fact that the Lakers earned one first down. Other than that, they have just gone backwards. Erickson puts the knee down and concedes the first half. This is the group that just made life miserable for Steve Erickson and the Lakers of Silver Lake. Rich Mraz started it with a dazzling 48-yard punt return. And as you look at the scoring, it was finished by an extremely more dazzling 84-yard run by Tim Stevenson. And Coach Joe Kelly and the Maroons have got to be happy, as at the break, they are comfortably in front, 28-0. Weymouth South, North Quincy highlights at the break. We'll be back with second half action after those highlights here on Dimension 36.
Hi, I'm film critic Bob Icardi. I hope you'll watch The Screening Room 3 times a week here on Dimension Cable, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 8 p.m. I'll review the new movies and tell you whether they're worthwhile or worthless. And I'll have plenty of great film clips to show you, too. So join me, Bob Icardi, in The Screening Room 3 nights a week here on Dimension Cable.
Weymouth South was looking for victory number 1 at Veterans Stadium when they took on the Red Raiders of North Quincy. Wildcats get off to a better start than they did against Quincy. Some good running by Ronnie Fernandez. But for every good step that the Wildcats did take, a bad one would happen. As J.J. Chella on this pass play to Matt Dineen on a 3rd-and-about-5 situation comes up short. And the Wildcats barely see the ball for the rest of the first half as North Quincy would move the ball. Despite this interception by Joe Broderick, which was called back because of a roughing the passer penalty on Weymouth South, the Wildcat defense would be on the field constantly throughout the first half, and they would be getting it taken to them by Jim Bryan, the senior quarterback for North Quincy, with this fine pass to Chris Deschler for a big gain of 25 yards out to the 46. And Dan Gilmartin on this run gets inside the Weymouth South 15, but the Wildcat defense stiffens and does not allow North Quincy anything as we head to second quarter action, where the Red Raiders do find the Weymouth South end zone. This great run, Dan Gilmartin, turning the corner, getting away from 1, 2, 3 tackles into the end zone for the touchdown. Chris Deschler hits the extra point, 7-0 North Quincy. And Coach Ken McPhee says, hey guys, we've got one touchdown, we can get more. As the Red Raider defense didn't allow anything to Weymouth South. In fact, this is the only first down for the Wildcats in the first half. This pass interference penalty against Bobby Layton, as J.J. Chella under enormous pressure throughout the first half. 4 times Chella was sacked by North Quincy. And the North Quincy offense got going. Jim Bryant to Kevin McDougal. on this crossing pattern. Over the middle, McDougal finally will be corralled at the Weymouth South 19 by Alan Good and a host of Weymouth South tacklers. Four plays later, Brian over the middle to Dave Kiley for the six-yard touchdown with Deschler's extra point. 14-0 Red Raiders at the break. As North Quincy control the first half very easily. Second half, good run here by J.J. Chellas. It looked like Weymouth South was getting it going. But like the first half, for every good step that the Wildcats took, they took one backwards. Chella, very next play, gets stormed under by a host of Red Raiders. The Weymouth South defense, it got tough in the second half as it tried to keep the ball club in the game. Dave Kiley being stopped after a short gain, but the Wildcat defense played a great deal on the field throughout this entire game as North Quincy tripled the number of plays that Weymouth South would run in this game. Good play here by Chad Morris. He wasn't fooled on that reverse as he stops Dave Gilmartin for a loss of one. Only points of the second half belong to North Quincy. And kicker Chris Deschler nailing this field goal from 21 yards out. 17-0 North Quincy. Weymouth South did have a little bit of offense in the second half. J.J. Chella flip over the middle to Todd Cusick. But not enough offense. North Quincy would own this night 17-0 as the Red Raiders held Weymouth South to just 31 total yards and only 20 plays. Stay tuned for second half action between Weymouth North and Silver Lake.
Remember the little white cloud that sat right down and cried.
To go along with sensational defenses, got them on top by the score of 28-0. As the last big play by the Maroons was the 84-yard kickoff return for the touchdown. Kickoff return, it should be pointed out, a scramble by Timmy Stevenson. Second half underway. Montorio 20. Montorio. Nice return out to about the 37-yard line. And we'll begin the second half with the Maroons up with a good-sized lead. And Danny Daly will take over at quarterback for the Maroons as Stevenson was shaken up just before the end of the first half. Nothing serious as he had an ice pack to the back of his neck. But Danny Daly will take over. And Daly runs the option with Mraz. Hurdles out to the 40-yard line. As Andy Alaconis on the tackle. As found out a number change for the Lakers. 31 is Andy Alaconis. Listed in the program originally as Mike Heavey, but Heavey out injured for this game. Second and seven. Henriksen bangs to midfield, and he's finally chopped down by Jared Snell. Snell held on for dear life at the ankles and waited for help and got it from a host of Lakers led by Jeff Milton, but Henriksen to the Laker 49. And the Maroons will just try to push the ball downfield on the ground with the 28-0 lead. Mraz with a marker down, gets inside the 45 to the 44, and the marker in the Maroon backfield in illegal motion. on the Maroons as Alakonis on the tackle. And the Lakers will probably take the penalty, make it first and 15. So Danny Daly, the junior, is getting a great deal of time as the quarterback, but mostly with the second team as Daly alternates as a starting wide receiver as well, but he will work with the first team this week. And Rich Mraz following a convoy back in the Silver Lake territory to the 49. Frank Martin knocks him out as you look at head coach Joe Kelly of Weymouth North, who's going to be very happy the way his team has bounced back after last week. A very hard-fought loss. And then, if you wonder if there were any ill effects, there were none. As Stevenson back in, Timmy throws it behind Chuck Montorio, who was open. Chuck was open on the play, but Timmy Stevenson just fired it behind him. And Montorio had to do a 360 to try to get near the football, and it's an incomplete pass, third down, with 7:54 to go in the third period, and the Maroons need 10 for the first down. As Timmy Stevenson back in the lineup, so apparently Timmy said he was okay and wants to play. As Stevenson caught Danny Lindblom, then dropped Danny Lindblom. Danny Lindblom had it right in his hands and had plenty of yards in the play that got the Maroons a touchdown earlier. Goes to an incompletion on this play. And Stevenson the punt. Timmy glides one. That will go into the end zone. And a 50-yard kick, as you see the mathematics, as far as this game goes. So the Lakers had two first downs in the first half, earned one of them. The other one was a gift by the Maroon defense on a personal foul penalty just at the end of the half. And Steve Erickson out in the shotgun. So the Lakers will try to pass the ball, and Erickson drops the snap and gets covered by Matt Deedy and John Torleone. As the two defensive tackles fall on top of Steve Erickson, and it'll be second down. And 16 for the Lakers. One difference as far as the Maroons go in this week is the fact that they have not forced any turnovers, something that they have been proficient in doing in the first 3 weeks of the season. As Erickson gets away from Ferrara and then just fires it downfield, intended for J.P. Duffy. Rich Mraz closed in, but Duffy was open. But Erickson scrambled for time and was able to get the ball downfield as Erickson bought himself realistically maybe a second or two more before the Maroon rush caved in on him. Third and 16. And maybe pass interference, it will be called on Jason Capello. Capello realistically did not have to do what he did in pushing Frank Martin, because no way that pass was being completed. But pass interference, Weymouth North
12 against Weymouth North.
And Silver Lake will get the first down because of it. Or check that. They will get the first down. It was just the margin of the penalty. It was a 5-yard mark off. So the Lakers getting a first down. And where they started this possession was on the 20, and they're starting with the first down on the 17 because of the penalty. Erickson on the draw. Didi will get credit for a tackle on Jared Snell, who just slipped and fell down.
Jeff Milton on the carry, Ross on the play.
Second down and 13. Next week, we'll be right back here at Legion Field as we will bring you the Weymouth South Wildcats and the Harbormen of Hingham. Here from Legion Field, highlights of Weymouth North and Bridgewater Raynham. As Erickson under pressure and incomplete. Intended for J.P. Duffy, David Layton on the coverage. And it'll be third down. As Erickson hit Chris Ferrara bearing down on him. And if you're a defensive lineman for Weymouth North, you've got to love the situation at the present time. Because all you can do is just take off and go after the passer. Erickson. Intercepted! Jason Capello! Capello, if he kept his feet, had a touchdown. But Jason gives the Maroons superb field position, the 10-yard line. And with 5:50 to go in the third period, and the Maroons up by 28, they will look to add even more to the lead as Jason Capello with a superb interception. He just dove in front of Frank Martin. As Henriksen fumble.
Flag on the play.
And the marker down, Silver Lake says they got the football. And no flags, and Silver Lake gets it back on the turnover as Henriksen had it jarred from him, and the Lakers recover. So Henriksen gets it to the 5. And just fumbles the football away. And Silver Lake. As Erickson just lost it out of his hands. And it'll be second down and 10 as Dawson, the intended receiver, on the play. But Erickson just had it go right out of his hands. And Weymouth North only had 10 players in on that defensive play. They still only have 10, and now Matt Deedy. Deedy trying to find out whether he's in there or not, and yes, he is in there. Matt turned around. Yes, I'm in there. I'll play this play. Confusion, and Snell gets the handoff, and Alex Provost finally collects him at about the 11-yard line. And Matt Deedy gets up slow. He was in on the tackle as well. It'll be third down and 4 for the Lakers and their best running play of the game so far, 6 yards. 5:12 to go and counting here in the third period, all Maroons. As the defense has just made sure that Silver Lake is not going anywhere. Erickson runs the option. David Layton was right there. And Erickson just tried to get rid of the football as Provost was also there for the Maroons.
Erickson on the carry.
And he got rid of the football to Andy Alaconis and ended up as being a three-yard loss. The Maroons were more in tune with that play than the Lakers were. And now timeout Silver Lake. As the Lakers did not have the right people on the field, and for Coach John Cucinato and his Lakers, it has been a very long night. Steve Ullo to punt again, and he has been a very busy individual. And he just hits it straight up in the air. And the Lakers will down it. Jeff Uva falls on it at the 27. And holding Weymouth North on the return will back up the Maroons even more. So Weymouth North, despite 28 points in the first half, did not, it should be pointed out, did not, has made some mistakes with the penalties. And they have made a few big mistakes as far as the penalties are, else realistically the Maroons could have an even bigger lead. And let's see where they're going to mark it. It's holding on Weymouth North. And we'll bring it back 10 yards from where it was downed. I do believe we'll put it back at the 38. And a third quarter that has basically been inside the Silver Lake half of the field. And now Tim Stevenson wants a timeout because not the right group of people are on the field. We'll talk to Coach Joe Kelly as they will talk about the fact that they're up by 28.
Session stand.
The Maroons from the 38 on a first and 10 situation go to Strazzeri, who gets caught from behind after about a 2-yard gain by Kevin Barrett. Barrett followed the play nicely. And Strazzeri gains a couple of yards. Second down, and it'll be 9 to go for the Maroons. Dive play, Hendrickson to the 30-yard line where Lou was brought down there. Hendrickson, 2 yards short of a first down. It'll be third down and 2 to go. And with 3:20 and counting to go, third period. The Maroons looking to add more to their lead. And first of all, getting the first down will be Hendrickson. Bulling his way to the 24-yard line.
Dawson made the stop.
Gladstone turns the corner. Darren with a marker down. Darren to the 10-yard line. But unfortunately for Weymouth North, there was a clip on the play. And Darren Gladstone's fine run will be wiped out. And we have an injured player for the Lakers with 2:36 to go here in the third period. And when we come back, Weymouth North will be faced with a first and long situation. Jeff Uva, the injured player, I believe you can see top of your screen for just a second that he was being helped off under his own power. Strazzeri on the counter. Open territory. Strazzeri. Touchdown. But a marker down on the play. May wipe out the Strazzeri touchdown run. Holding, Weymouth North will wipe out the nice run by sophomore Keith Strazzeri. As the counter play got excellent yardage, and then all of a sudden, a not needed penalty puts the Maroons back with a first down and 10 at the 25 where we started.
No first down.
Originally the line of scrimmage for the Maroons. An excellent point by director Dal Ketchum is the fact that if this was a close game, this could be very interesting with the penalties. Strazzeri will try it again, not as successful in the amount of yardage he gained on the last carry. As Lopes in on the tackle, but Strazzeri does get first down yardage. And 135 and counting, and the Maroons just looking to glide into the end zone one more time. And just make this an easy game for themselves. As Mike Canina, the sophomore, gets inside the 10, down to the 7. As Canina, brought down by Mike Dawson. And Canina, they said, makes it to the 8. It'll be 7 yards, second and 7. Second and 3 for a first down, and 8 for a touchdown. Canina, again, inside the 5 to about the 4. And a first and goal situation coming up. As Mike Canina getting some valuable time. And a timeout by Silver Lake. They want to discuss what is going on for them as they trail Weymouth North 28 to nothing. 41 seconds to go, third quarter. Weymouth North up 28 nothing, looking for more. It's going to be Darren Gladstone making it to the 3.
Darren Gladstone stops at the line of scrimmage.
Weymouth North playing their stable of sophomore backs on this possession.
Second down.
Strazzeri, Gladstone, Canina. Three very talented running backs. Canina. Bulls to the 1. On what will be the final play of the third period. We'll head 99 yards down to the other end of Legion Field. And the Maroons will begin the fourth quarter looking to bang in a few nails to the coffin. 28-0 Weymouth North.
Every year, thousands of babies die from choking, suffocating, or other breathing emergencies. Just imagine how many of them could be saved if only they came with instructions. Please learn American Red Cross Infant and Child CPR. American Red Cross, we help you help others.
Fourth quarter about to start, and the Maroons up 28 to nothing, looking to add to what has been a very impressive showing by them, especially defensively. They have allowed very little for Silver Lake. The offense has done the big plays. It is going to be touchdown, Jason Capello. Jason Capello with a hole that you could have... Anybody could have scored on. Just bowled his way into the end zone, and the Maroons make it 34-0. As the senior captain, getting his second touchdown of the year, and Tim Stevenson, who is 4-for-4 on extra points. Stevenson 5-for-5 on point after kicks. And 9:56 to go, and the Maroons will be heading to 3-1 very impressively. Jason Capello finishing off the Maroon drive, a very short drive, with a 1-yard touchdown run to begin the fourth quarter. And the Maroons, after stumbling last week, have bounced back this week very, very impressively. And Danny Daly getting some opportunities to kick off this year, as Darren Gladstone hunted down J.P. Duffy and brought him down at the 28. And 9:50 to go, and remind you, next week, Weymouth South and Hingham, right here from Legion Field, Weymouth North, Bridgewater, Raynham highlights. As the Wildcats, we are taping this game, are playing the Red Raiders of North Quincy. Erickson, dump off, Duffy, Danny Lindblom there to bring him down at the 30 for a 1-yard gain. And some new shirts in the Maroon defense. Danny Daly getting an opportunity to get in some work. Danny Lindblom defensively. A new pair of linebackers, Sean Small and P.J. Bronchuk. And with a 35-0 lead, the opportunity is there. Snell on the draw. Runs over Bronchuk as he pushes his way to the 38 for a 7-yard gain. And it'll be third down and one for a Laker first down. Steve Erickson and company on third and a yard. Go to the ground for a first down to the 41-yard line. Frank Martin, or check it, Andy Alaconis, getting that first down run. As Jimmy Francis getting some work at defensive end, makes the tackle. Go, let's go, let's go. 8:08 and counting left in the game, and it's been Weymouth North playing very splendid football as Lopes, on the toss pitch, gets cut down by 31, Sean Small. As Lopes loses a yard, as Sean Small, from his linebacker position, came across and cut down Lopes. And it'll be second and 11. There's a look at the Maroon defense. And we've been highlighting them a great deal in this game for good reason. They have been absolutely strong in this game. As Erickson, under pressure, tried to hit J.P. Duffy on the deep corner route, but overthrown Danny Daly on the coverage. But Steve Erickson had a lot of people just blowing up the middle in maroon and gold shirts, putting the pressure on him. And the Lakers are just trying to get something for themselves next week to build on, something to build on towards next week. Some little spark of momentum, and they will try to get back to the drawing board and get that first victory. The Maroons will try to keep their newfound momentum against Bridgewater Raynham as Jared Snell on the draw, nowhere. In fact, loses a yard. John Torleone and Danny Daly tackle him. 7 to go, Silver Lake. Punting. As they've gotten two first downs by penalties, two first downs on their own. And as that is how the Maroons have just done them in tonight with the defense. As on mark it down, P.J. Bronchuk fields the punt and gets tackled. As the marker in the Silver Lake backfield, roughing the kicker, Weymouth North. And now the old talk about that, roughing the kicker or running into the kicker. The roughing is 15, running into him is just a 5. And if it's a first down, that is being marked off, 15-yard personal foul. The one thing that the North High coaching staff will be looking at as far as this game goes are the penalties. They have got to be very, very disappointed in their team as far as in that aspect of the game. Silver Lake, 5 first downs, 3 by penalties. And the Lakers will be changing up as far as the offense goes and getting the first down. Quarterback will be Jason McCann, number 13. He's a sophomore. Giving off to Lopes. Marcus Lopes gains a yard to the 44. It'll be second down. As Danny Daly in on the tackle. .548, .547. As the clock just ticking off here at Legion Field. And the Maroons in just that far away from getting ready to celebrate a very strong victory as Lopes gets to the 40. P.J. Bronchuk and Chuck Montorio in on the tackle. As Lopes gains 4, 3rd and 5.
We have a 3rd down and 5.
Lopes again gets away from Daly, but does not get away from Darren Gladstone, who along with P.J. Bronchuk bring down Lopes after a 3-yard game. 4th and 2 for a first down. It's P.J. Bronchuk. Darren Gladstone stopping Lopes short. Up back as a marker down. And it may be on Silver Lake for a legal procedure. Offsides Weymouth North. So the Lakers will get the first down. 6 first downs, 4 by the penalty route. And the Maroons must be heading towards the 100-yard mark in penalties in this game.
Ball now on the 33-yard line.
Is this Laker drive realistically being kept alive by the penalty route? A roughing the kicker call And offsides, getting a first down. It's Tom Cahill. Apparently looked like he had moved prior to the snap, but they said no, it's McCann, the left-hander. Intercepted, check Montorio. Montorio to the Silver Lake. 45-yard line is check Montorio's fifth interception of the year. As that ball just hung up there, and Montorio and company, and all he had to do was just run under it and make the catch and head downfield. As you look at line coach Tony Manzelli directing the troops and what he wants done on this segment of downs, which should be Danny Daly orchestrating. Gladstone in trouble. Gladstone gets away and inside the 40 to the 38. Tommy Cahill and Chris Hackett make the tackle. But Joe Aloka had a great opportunity to bring Gladstone down for no gain. But Darren turns what should have been a no gain, maybe loss of one, into a 4-yard gain. Kanina, nicest way, inside the 30 to the 27, where Matt Ashbury brings him down. It's Weymouth North just shuffling the backs in there behind some new linemen.
227 left to play.
35-0, 2:20 to go, and Coach Joe Kelly has just been shuffling the troops primarily in the second half. And no matter what combination, it has been basically successful. Shazeri. Waited and got good blocking and first down to the 15 and another first down. McCarthy on the tackle. As the Maroons showing their speed, and Silver Lake wants to talk about it with 1:51 left. All Maroons, they lead by a bundle. Whistles blow on first and 10. And Kanina was just rumbling towards the end zone, but it will be against Weymouth North. What else is new? Procedure Weymouth North. I've always wondered one thing. In the years I've done football, no matter for what concern I've ever done it for, whether it be a newspaper concern or a Dimension Cable or on the radio, I've always wondered how teams can be up by a large margin and get a great deal of penalties. It's Kanina to the 17. I've always wondered that. How a team running away and hiding and will have more penalty yardage than the team they are playing, who is down, and you figure the team that is down will be trying to scratch and claw and get themselves back into a game or try to make something happen. Option Gladstone, marker down. Gladstone, touchdown. It will be called back, however. Darren Gladstone was getting his first varsity touchdown, but they're going to call a penalty on Weymouth North. And that is not a good call. That was not a good call. They'll say a clip on Weymouth North, but in looking at that play and watching it unfold, that was not a good call. Because that play, in all sincerity, Looks like a very clean block that sprung Darren Gladstone free. Touchdown himself, or let's see where they'll mark it. Kanina gets it to the one. They'll say that Kanina was down. First down, Weymouth North and goal, as Kanina just blew up the middle. And he looked like he had an easy touchdown for himself, but he was caught at the one by Matt Ashbury. And Danny Daly just looking for one person. What play to call? 29 seconds of counting. That's all that's left. Daly takes it himself. Touchdown, Weymouth North. Danny Daly. Quarterback sneak for the touchdown. And maroon and gold has been going for its sixth rendition tonight. 15 seconds left. And the Maroons just explode. It's a die play for the two-point conversion will fail. The night belongs to the Weymouth North Maroon defense. Convincingly, they are just rolling to victory number three. Danny Daly got a touchdown the first week of the season on a pass reception. He takes over at quarterback and gets a run for a touchdown himself to finish off the six-play drive. And the Maroons have been dazzling with the defense. And they have really just rocked around the clock tonight against Silver Lake. Lakers a little banged up, but still, the Maroons have just been executing. Bumped down at the 29. John McGowan in on the tackle of Jason McCann in time for maybe one or two plays, 10 seconds to go. And after 3 years of Barry Barasa, tough football games with Silver Lake, this one turned into a rout because the Maroons just had more horses to rely on. As the final play of the game, 41-0 Weymouth North. Rich Mraz get it going with a punt return of 48 yards. And then after that, it was all Weymouth North. They just made sure of it. They just rolled through Silver Lake. As they used the big play in the first half, two touchdowns in the second half, and Weymouth North was wondering if they would rebound after last week against Silver Lake. They did just that, as the Maroons put away the Lakers in impressive fashion, 41-0. As the Maroons go to 3-1, the Lakers drop to 0-4. As that will do it here from Legion Field. For director Dale Ketchum, I'm Mark Deshaun. I'm glad you joined us. The Maroons, impressively, 41-0. Good night. We'll see you for Weymouth South Hingham football next week.